Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what your dog thinks when you talk to them. I'm sure many of us here have a pet dog, and I'm sure just as many people speak to their dogs as if they were people sometimes. You may think this is just for your benefit, but what's your dog actually thinking when you speak to them? Well, believe it or not, your dogs probably can actually understand you a lot more than you think. Today we're going to look at some new experiments with dogs. We're also going to find out if they understand speech, body language, and emotions, why they can understand us, and also how you can better communicate with your furry friend. But first, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? Believe it or not, there have been many studies all about dogs' cognition. This is basically dogs' ability to understand humans. This research goes all the way back to the 1800s and is still carried out today. One professor named Brian Hare from Emory University did a study in 2000. He found that dogs can understand and relate to people's words, emotions, and body language. Obviously, in history, they didn't have the technology that we have today. And that's why a new study done by a group named Frontiers in Neuroscience is so amazing. They trained 12 dogs to retrieve two differently named objects. And they then measured the dog's brain activity using an MRI scanner. One was a toy pig named Pig, and the other was a toy monkey named Monkey. The dog was trained to differentiate between these two toys. And then when the scientist said, "Go get the pig," the dog did go to the pig. And sure enough, when it said go get the monkey, the dog went and retrieved the monkey toy. So dogs can clearly recognize names for things. This means dogs will likely recognize their own names, and also the names of people in your family. They may need some training for this, but their cognition definitely stretches to those limits. The scientist also did another test simultaneously. As well as Pig and Monkey, they said some gibberish words, such as Bobu and Bodmik. When they did that, the dog went to other objects they had around the room. In one instance, the dog went over to a hat, and in another instance, the dog went over to a doll. But when they did this while measuring with an MRI brain scanner, they found something amazing. They found dogs' brains light up more when they hear words they've never heard before. This is actually the opposite to how human brains work. Human brains react much more strongly to words we know. That's why when you're in a foreign country, you can hear people who speak the same language as you over everyone else. Really, they're speaking at the same or a quieter level. But because human brains light up more when they hear words they understand, it means you can hear these words much more clearly. So, why do dogs' brains light up more when they hear random words they've never heard before? Well, the scientist said, unlike humans who can immediately tell gibberish, dogs can't always make this differentiation. They may actually be trying harder to please their owners to receive food or praise. So, after all of these experiments have been carried out, can we actually say for sure, do dogs understand speech or not? Well, the answer is partly. In 2004, Science Magazine did a study on a dog named Rico. They did something called fast mapping new words to this dog. This is kind of similar to how you learn language as a child. You don't know what things are called, so the first time you hear a word, that is ingrained in your brain. Using this technique, they were able to teach Rico the names of 200 different items. And within just 4 weeks of training, he was able to identify most of them and retrieve them from a room. But dogs actually understand more than just words. A study by the University of Sussex in the UK found that dogs can actually pick up on emotional cues in our speech. Dogs process the meanings of words on the left side of their brain, but on the right side of their brains, they process the emotional cues in our words. This means they can understand the difference between good boy and bad boy. They can basically tell if we're angry when speaking or happy when speaking. So, dogs can partially understand speech, but can they understand our body language? In 2012, a study was carried out which heavily suggests dogs understand our body language. Dogs were presented with two different servings of food, one big and one small. Naturally, most of the dogs went for the larger serving. But then they did the same experiment, but with people involved. It seemed that when people were involved, the portion size did not matter. Instead, it was all about the people's body language. The dogs would never go to somebody with an angry or sad body language. But no matter what the portion size was, people with a friendly and happy body language, the dogs would always go to. Also, when you're communicating with your dog, you should always look at your dog. That's because they can actually recognize this part of body language. A study found that dogs have the similar brain capacity to a 6 to 12 month year old human baby. And that applies to recognizing when they're being directly addressed or having information conveyed to them. For example, in one test, a person said, "Hi dog," while looking away from the dog. They did this many times, and most of the time the dog did not look back at the human. However, while they did the same test, while the person looked at the dog while saying "Hi dog," the dog looked way more often. It seemed it judged body language when differentiating when someone was talking to them and not talking to them. In both situations, the dog would have been able to hear, but only when the dog was being looked at did it realize it was being directly addressed. And on that subject, do dogs understand our emotions? We've already covered they can understand our emotional cues when we're speaking, but what about just by looking? Can they tell if a human's happy or sad? A study by the University of Lincoln found dogs can differentiate between human emotions based on facial expressions. However, they noted dogs may not be able to tell the difference between positive and negative emotional states. For example, they can tell the difference between a frowning face and a smiling face, but they don't necessarily know that smiling is a positive thing and frowning is a negative thing. But that begs the question, why can dogs understand us? Well, the cool thing about this is that the reason why dogs are capable of understanding us so well is actually a mystery. Some scientists say this is a product of evolution and necessity. That's because for thousands of years, dogs and humans have lived very closely together. And a lot of the time, dogs do depend on humans. Many dogs today are bred specifically for humans. This is either for humans to use as pets or to use in jobs. For example, farm dogs, police dogs, or racing dogs. So it only makes sense that when one species depends on another so much, they would need to communicate and understand us. But now that you have all of this information, you're probably asking, how can I communicate better with my dog? Well, the first thing you can do is pay more attention to how you speak to your dog. You can actually train your dog much better if you use emotional cues in your voice. It may sound silly, but when you tell your dog off, make sure you do it in an angry voice. And when you're being affectionate to your dog and praising it, make sure you do it in a very happy voice, kind of like you would to a baby. This may sound funny, but based on research, this actually works to train your dog a lot better. Also, if you want to get your dog's attention, make sure you actually look in its direction when saying its name. This will improve your dog's ability to understand you're actually directly addressing it and not just saying something to someone else. And finally, make sure you always call your dog something consistent. Most people have a name for their dog, but every now and then they'll say something like "good boy." Instead of saying "good boy," you should actually use your dog's name all the time. This will help to cement that name in your dog's mind and realize that that's them you're talking about. This will allow you and your dog to have a closer connection and for them to understand you better and vice versa. Check out the poll in the top right corner to vote for if you have a dog or not. And if you guys want some more amazing videos, then why not check out my second channel? There'll be a link to that coming up on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.